Welcome to the 8th edition of World Intellectual Property Forum. The inaugural ceremony will be starting in few minutes.
Let me congratulate the organizers for organizing this very important event on promoting a new culture, not just in India, but all over the world, to protect each other's intellectual properties. God has endowed each one of us with intelligence. The intelligence enables us to create new ideas, new products, new technologies, new ways of doing business, the new approach completely that enables the God-given intelligence to promote good for the world. But everybody appreciate that my idea should be protected for a simple reason, is that's my idea. If there are only copycats who will going to copy others' ideas, then the world will never have innovation. Because everybody would like to be copying others' ideas. And what will happen as a result of that? The result would be that new ideas will never get born. Because everybody is trying to copy the old idea. And therefore, protecting somebody's idea enables creation of new ideas. Because if somebody has created a good idea and is going to get rewarded for it, monetarily or otherwise, he's going to get recognition for it globally or otherwise, others will get encouraged to follow him. And how will they follow him? Not by copying him, because that idea is already known to others as his idea. So the others will get motivated to come out with a better idea than the one who has been getting such acknowledgement. And that would promote the kind of competitive spirit that is necessary to promote new ideas in the world, which in turn will promote the growth of the world. New ideas will promote global good. Therefore, we really need to protect it. I'm very happy that my friend Mr. Agarwal and his colleagues are working on this idea for a long time. They, being good lawyers, obviously try to protect others' rights, and they use their knowledge to protect that. But also they realize that as a good lawyer, the law must be protected. Law must be respected. Law must be followed. And luckily, in India, we have a law which is TRIPS compatible, which protects, promotes, encourages new intellectual property to be born. Whenever it is born, we have ability to protect it by filing necessary papers with the requisite authorities. In fact, when I was a Commerce Industry Minister, we had invested a lot of our energy, including financial resources, to upgrade all this, to make sure that we'll follow not just international best practices, but over a period of time, we'd like to be even better than that and set a new benchmark for ourselves. Because India has always been a place where new ideas have born from thousands of years. And some of those ideas, we never cared to get it registered as an IPR. The good example is yoga or Vedas. We never ask anybody to go and protect it. But that is a completely different world. In today's modern world, it is important that we must protect it. That's why we have a law. Then, having registered it, we have now working on enforceability of it. So in fact, I used to have many programs as Commerce Industry Minister to bring in all the regulators, all the police officers, all the administrators in the country to encourage them to enforce it, because law is good as it is enforced. So we don't have enforceability with no law. So we should bring that. Then comes awareness, and we were also working on that, creating awareness of it in a very significant way so that people will respect it, adopt it, and follow it. So we are actually doing that. And as I said about the TRIPS, which is the internationally accepted regime for intellectual property, and we have been following it. Now in the new environment, wherein in the last few months, the world is learning new lessons. We are realizing the pandemic can affect the whole world very swiftly, without notice. And that can cause huge damage to the entire humanity. Socio-economic life will get affected. Therefore, we are working on now ensuring as a global community, in fact, as a G20, is also seized with this matter, and we are trying to find out how can we work in effective way to fight pandemic as a collaborative effort. But how do you fight pandemic? We need a vaccine. Till we find vaccine, we need other measures. But each of these needs innovation, ideas, new technological development, and all of that would need protection of an intellectual property right. And therefore, I would urge my friends that even life-threatening issues like pandemics can be dealt only with innovation. And innovations can happen only when there is a protection for that innovation. Therefore, we must follow that in a very effective way and find out how can each one of us protect that in a significant way. There's other key element to this. One is the pandemic. Other is our Prime Minister's clarion call for making India Atmanirbhar, a place where everybody will get completely not depend on government, but will become stronger. And to do that, we'll have to work in such a way that people will be able to stand their own feet. That means they'll have to start their own enterprises. Now, when you start an enterprise, there are various ways you can engage into an enterprise, by manufacturing something, by providing services. You'll never get a value for your service or for a product unless it is a new innovative idea. And that again needs protection. So Atmanirbhar Bharat needs Atmanirbhar intellectual property. It needs homegrown ideas which can become globally scalable over a period of time. And to do that, we need to find out the best way of working in collaboration with innovators and manufacturers, with new ideas and protecting those ideas in an effective way. So I am very happy that this conference, global conference, which is taking place today, will also focus on how do we make small and medium enterprises also develop new ideas, focus on new innovative challenges that will come in the way. So I'm very happy that you are doing it. The entire ecosystem of innovation rests on intellectual properties, and protecting them only will ensure new ideas getting born. So let me offer my congratulations, best wishes, and hope that all of you will take it forward. Thank you very much.